Hi friends, today I am discussing about the stochastic gradient descent optimizer. So what is a stochastic gradient descent optimizer and why it is called stochastic gradient descent? Stochastic means random. So and the gradient descent is I will discuss about the stochastic gradient descent. Stochastic gradient descent, it is an optimization algorithm used to minimize some function by iteratively moving in the direction of steepest descent as defined by the negative of the gradient. Means it do iterations by moving downwards to find global minima. Why we find global minima? At the global minima, the loss is very less. That is the main objective of the stochastic gradient descent. So it goes to steepest means valley point in the normal meaning. So it go downwards. Normally we call it as a negative of the gradient. So why we go for stochastic gradient descent? Already we have gradient descent because the gradient descent is converges very slowly. Why it converges very slowly? Because it optimizes every data point by point by point. So if we have more data set, massive data set, it takes more time to optimize or find global minima. To avoid this problem, you go for stochastic gradient descent. How stochastic gradient descent eliminate this problem? Because in the name itself, stochastic means, I already said, random. It randomly select the data points in the data set and optimize. Due to this reason, it converges very fastly. And there is a disadvantage due to this point, because we are randomly selecting the data, the noise may be increases. This is the disadvantage of stochastic gradient descent. So this is the theory about the stochastic gradient descent. So let's go for implementation. So this is the weight update formula. So W, current weight minus eta, learning rate into different gradient of weight. So it means we call it as a next system. Future weight equal to current weight minus eta, learning rate into gradient of weight. So eta is not changed at time. We give defaultly. And these are the importing libraries to implement this optimizer. I am taking this function to calculate the gradients. And I am implementing this function using lambda. Lambda is an anonymous function in Python. So first I am calculate the gradients. So these are the first order differential optimizers. So we need to do differentiation for first time. So all terms have a square. So if you do first time differentiation, the all square terms comes before this function. So we need to do differentiation two times with respect to x and with respect to y, because this consists of two variables. See, all two comes before the function, and I am converting this to array, and I am storing in the grads variable, and I am building the optimizer. I'm taking the class as a gradient descent optimizer, and these are the parameters to implement this optimizer. Function gradients, I am giving a scale. Self.weights means W. I am initializing weights with zeros, and I am giving X and Y values. If you don't give, I give uniform distribution from -3.0 to +3.0, same as Y. And I am printing the X and Y values. I am giving the learning rate, and I am giving empty list for storing the loss functions. And this is the function, which function you need to optimize. And I'm giving variables. So I have these variables because in your function variables will be present, and I am giving that variables to X and Y. I'm storing in the Z, and I am calculating that function gradients using gradient function. And this is the weight update. So this is the formula to implement. W next weight equal to current weight minus learning rate into weight of the gradient of weight. self dot vars equal to self dot vars minus self dot learning rate into gradient. And history update, and I appending the all values to x, y, z, and I am starting training. I am giving number of steps. Up to that steps, this training will be continued. So I am starting with the zero. I am printing the every value x, y, z and function value, and I am creating a this file to store the values. So up to that steps, some steps will be run. That are function, weight update, history update, gradients. So I am sure this functions need to run at every step. So I am creating a for loop to run these functions, and I am printing the values and store it in that file. For every 100 value, I am printing the values x, y, z, and I am comparing. I am giving a threshold to if need to for observing convergence is occurred or not. So I am printing the value, and I am updating the final values, and I am closing the loop for loop, and I am assigning previous value and last value, and I am converting this x y values to array, and I am concatenating, and I am printing the every value. So thank you friends watching this video. Please subscribe my channel and please press bell icon. Thank you.